Hello everyone, in this video we will teach you some points about time.
They are game speed, stopping the game, run animations in a stop mode, how to work with Time.deltaTime, timer in Unity, and IEnumerator. The first point about time in Unity is to change the speed in the game. First, create an animation for your object to see the speed change in the game. As you can see in the animation, the character moves left and right at the speed you see. Open the script that you created for the game object and give it to the game object. The speed management in Unity is done by TimeScale. The TimeScale number is 1 by default. If you play, you will see that the game speed is normal. If you change the TimeScale to 2, you will see that the game speed is exactly doubled. If you change it to 3, the game speed will triple, etc. Also, if you change the timing below 1, the game will slow down. If you put 0.2 instead of 2, the game will be very slow. Second point is about stopping the game. To stop the game, create a void first like stop. Then set the time scale to 0. Anytime this void runs, the whole game will stop. To run a stop void, create a button. Then drag the object which you created before and select the stop void from function section. Now if you play, you will see after click on the stop button, time scale equals to 0 and the game stops. If you wanna the game continues, you only need to create a void which in it time scale equals to 1. Third point is about how to prevent affecting time on animation. It means when you want to stop the game, some animations keep playing. For example, you have a pause menu that pops up with animation when its active is set to true. Now if you stop the game and through the pause menu set active, you will see that the menu animation not runs. Why? Because time scale is 0. To prevent animations from stopping in the pause mode, click on object which is the pause menu and change the update mode to unscaled time from the animator section. In this way, if time scale equals to 0 or game stops, animation will execute without any problem. Now if you play and click on the stop button which activates pause menu, you will see that the pause menu's animations runs correctly. You can throw pause menu set active from a script instead of do it in the game scene. When you click on the stop button, you will see that the game will stop without any problem and the pause menu will appear with animation. The fourth point is about in-game movements. To stabilize game speed on all platforms, speed must be multiplied by time.deltaTime. For example, suppose this object is going to move to the right. For this, open objects script. You can move your object in different ways. It doesn't matter which way you choose. You just need to multiply the speed by time.deltaTime. This is what matters. Why? Because if you don't do this, the speed of movement in one phone may be different from the speed of movement in another phone. Now this movement could be translate, position, or something else. It doesn't matter. Just speed must get multiplied by time.deltaTime. The fifth point is about how to create a timer. Suppose we have a number that we want to increase every second. For this, open the script. Since you are dealing with UI, use UnityEngine.UI, then define a text and a float. To increasing the number plus equal define a float with 1 times time.deltaTime. In this way, each 1 second the number increases by 1. For displaying the number, equal define a text with define a float dot to a string. Now drag the script to object, then give text to it, then play. You can see this number increases by 1 in every second. If you want to round the displaying number, just open the code and do this. Instead of number.toString, write this. In this way, the float number changes to integer when displayed. Now after play, you will see the number increases 1 by 1. The last point is about how to work with IEnumerators. What it means, sometimes we want after a special time, like 2 seconds, something happens. For this, we use IEnumerators. First of all, open the script, then write a void. For example, wait. In it, write start cruddy. In parentheses, write the name of IEnumerator void which I define ahead. Name it late, for example. Lower, define a IEnumerator. Write this IEnumerator space, its name which we use late, and open close parentheses. In its body, write yield return new, wait for seconds, and write in parentheses that after how many seconds you want the following command to be executed. For example, 2 seconds. And below it, write a command. For example, I write print bot games. Now drag the script to the game object. Then give game object to button and choose wait void from function section. And press play button. Now if you click on this click button, after 2 seconds, bot games should be printed. If it didn't happen, I would delete this YouTube account. Now you see after 2 seconds, bot games is printed. Now you can put any other commands instead of print bot games. Isn't bot games lovely? Why you don't like and subscribe then?
Thanks for watching. Next tutorial is about daily reward.